In this illustration, I will analyze two liquids in a circular tube. Here we are given that the figure shows a circular tube of a small cross section in which equal volumes of two liquids which do not mix into each other are filled. And here each liquid occupies 1/4 length of the tube. That means each liquid is subtending an angle 90° at the center of this tube. And it is saying if densities of liquids are rho and sigma with the value of rho greater than sigma, we are required to find the angle alpha which the liquid junction makes with the vertical at center in equilibrium state. Here we can analyze the situation as the liquid is in equilibrium. Then we can calculate the pressure at bottom. That should be same if we calculate it from both the sides. So here to analyze it, I'll redraw the figure of this tube. And in this case of tube, this is a situation when the junction is making an angle alpha. This is one liquid filled here, which is of density rho. And here is another liquid, which is of density sigma. So if this angle is alpha, this will also be alpha. And we can consider this level is say at some height above the level. Here you can see with respect to bottom, if we analyze, we can see this height, say it is H3. And this height we consider as H2. The level of junction above the base of this tube, and say this height above the level H2, or from the junction to the top level of another liquid is say H1. Then we can write at equilibrium, of a liquid, the pressure at bottom is given as, and if we calculate the pressure at bottom, then from right side it can be given as P atmospheric plus this H3 rho G. And the same must be, if we calculate the pressure from left side, it is P atmospheric plus H1 sigma G plus H2 rho G, as this is another liquid and this is one liquid. In this situation, P atmospheric gets cancelled out. And if we substitute the value of H3, H1 and H2, then H3 you can directly write, if this angle is alpha, this will be 90 minus alpha, so this we can write R1 minus sine alpha multiplied by rho g is equals to H1. Here we can write this R cos alpha plus R sine alpha. So this is R multiplied by cos alpha plus sine alpha multiplied by sigma g plus, if we get the value of H2, here you can see this is R1 minus cos alpha multiplied by rho g. Here g also gets cancelled out in this equation, and R also gets cancelled out. And here if we simplify this relation, finally after opening and simplifying, this will give us cos alpha multiplied by rho minus sigma is equals to sine alpha multiplied by rho plus sigma. Here you can take the terms of sine alpha and cos alpha on the two sides of equality. So this gives us the value of tan alpha is equals to rho minus sigma by rho plus sigma. So the value of alpha we are getting is tan inverse of rho minus sigma upon rho plus sigma. That is the result of this problem.